if you love something, if you love what you're doing, and you give in to the conditions, hindi natatawar. Priceless.
You've been part of Cinemalaya many, many times.
Now. Yes, as a actor, kaya nahahaba kasi yung speech ko doon. But I also, I've been a jury for Cinemalaya, a host, presenter, a segment host, etc., etc.
Now you won.
Yeah, and it's my first time to win.
Oh, so this is very special.
Yeah. Very, very special. Kasi sabi nga, after 15 years.
You find your
huh? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so tears of joy.
Yes.
Yep. Was it hard for you to accept the role?
Well, when I read the material, sabi ko it's quite daring and very simple. Ganon yung ano ko. It's a very simple material. But then, nung nakausap pa yung director, isa lang ang tinanong niya sa akin, if I'm willing to do the very delicate scenes. Tapos ang sabi lang niya, huwag ka mag-alala, Sir Ricky. Magfo-foots ka kami, foots pa kaming lahat. Well, okay. Sige, so tinanggap ko yun. And I accepted the material dahil napanood ko ang movie ni director Eduardo Roy, yung Pamilya Ordinaryo, and I loved it. So, because of that, sabi ko, I said yes, and I really want to work with him.
Yung bang Come to Mommy and Party, nasa script yun o personal touch?
Nasa script yun. Oh. Nasa script yun. Nasa script lahat.
So yung delivery is your own?
Well, yeah. Kasi nung first take, nung party, pagkat, they all laughed and shouted and ano. Sabi ko, why, what's ano?
So how did you prepare? Kasi napanood ko yung film, sobrang daring and you went out of the comfort zone, like Manzi.
Yeah, well, I'm an actor and I practice what I preach. Kung ano man yung kailangan ng na requirement for an actor, it's either gawin mo o hindi. Kung hindi mo kayang gawin, na talagang katalong ka sa swimming pool na walang tubig, una ulo, huwag mong gawin. Pero kung kaya mo, do it and then do it wholeheartedly para talagang bundo.
Tsaka, Derek, kahit na wala ka sa eksena, you were casting a large shadow throughout the film.
Well, that's the director. That's the material. Well, of course, my representation here is on the dark side, sa LGBT. Pero again, siyempre hindi naman lahat ng sector may mabango at maganda. Meron din naman dark sector and of course, kailangan din maging ma-represent yon sa society para makita nila na ano yung dapat nilang iwasan siguro. So,
Direct, okay, is it double the effort compared to Annie?
Oh yeah. Iba, Annie was a breeze kasi masaya naman yon, simple lang, and I'm working with a little, a boy, diba? A young boy there.
So what's next for Mr. Ricky Davao? Are you planning to go back to the director's chair?
Presently, I'm directing a teleserye, telenovela for GMA dahil sa pag-ibig. But I'm still an actor, so I still want to do a lot of films. Pero hopefully, I also dream of directing my own film. Probably dito sa Cinemalaya. Hopefully, if I get... hindi ako marunong sumulat. Kahit love letter, hindi ako marunong sumulat. But if I find a good material na ipapadirect sa akin, then I'll do it. Hopefully, sa Cinemalaya.
Bilang isang director, last question to direct. Hindi ba sa'yo mayroon pag-adjust yung pag-actor ka working with younger directors?
Hindi naman. Kasi nung nag-umpisa ako mag-direct, unang-una sa maalaala mo kaya, that was 1997 or 96. After doing that, after directing a full story of maalaala mo kaya, na-realize ko ang hirap pala maging director. Talagang 1,000% ang naging respeto ko sa mga director. Dahil napakahirap to start, to have a middle and an end ng isang storya na ide-direct mo. Napakahirap. Kaya sumobrang laki talaga ng respeto ko. Kahit sa mga director na gumawa ng pelikula, hindi ko nagustuhan. Saludo pa rin ako sa kanila dahil napakahirap maging director.
Thank you very much.
Yes, can we take photos?
Sure. Yeah, photos.
Filipo, tumayo. Very, very proud Ricky Davao here.